I'll believe for 1 second. You'll all see.
Golden pony boy. I'm not fucking. What the problem is? Problem last.
My presence.
Oh, looks better.
Look at that. Action.
There's some action. Waving action. Feeling good. Feeling flimsy. Feeling frisky. Got her nips out. Got her duke out. Yeah, I think we're good. I think we're golden, man. Might actually be golden.
Look at that.
Look at those boys dance. Look at those boys wiggle.
That's good.
It wiggle like a couple of goddamn pros, dude. They know their shit. I'm not gonna be watching Twitch, but that's okay. Be watching
Twitch
YouTube.
Is still connecting. Whatever. Should we start anyways?
Yeah, we should.
Hello.
Twitch is good, my friend. Look.
Oh, there it is.
We're online.
Welcome.
Welcome. Welcome to the beginner's guide, made by the dudes that did the Stanley Parable.
Now, in.
You want to scooch over to the right just a little bit so I can get in frame here?
Let me scoop.
Yeah. All right. Let me just.
Should I controller? By mouse and
keyboard. I don't know if there's a controller option, but you can try it out.
No, I'll just go mouse.
Because it is plugged
in.
I'll
just go mouse and keyboard.
So if yeah.
I'll just go mouse and key.
Whatever you want to, dude.
Again. Beginner's guide.
Uh oh, we're getting a little lag again. We were fine for a second.
Yeah, she does.
Yeah.
The audio is.
Are you sure?
That's the key to the WASD.
Hi there.
Hey.
Thank you very much for playing the Beginner's Guide.
Get it.
My name is Davey Reedon.
I
wrote the Stanley Parable. And while that game tells a pretty absurd story, today I'm going to tell you about a series of events that happened between 2008 and 2011.
Sounds good.
We're going to look at the games made by a friend of mine named Coda. Now, these games mean a lot to me. I met Coda in early 2009 at a time when I was really struggling with some personal stuff, and his work pointed me in a very...
Sorry. Sorry. Sorry, I'm just gonna pause this because we don't need to watch ourselves on two different things.
Nah.
Powerful direction.
Oh, there we go.
To be a good
right where we left off.
For the kinds of creative works that I wanted to make. So just to start you off, this is, I think, the first game he ever made. It's a level for Counter-Strike.
Cool.
You can walk around here, by the way.
Cool.
And mostly it's just Coda learning the basics of building a 3D environment. But what I like is that even though he starts from the simple aesthetic of a desert town, he then scatters these colorful abstract blobs and impossible floating crates around the level.
Absolutely.
And of course, it destroys the illusion that this actually is a desert town, and instead this level becomes a kind of calling card from its creator. It's like a reminder that this video game was constructed by a real person. And it kind of makes you wonder,
by an idiot.
What was
by
going through his head as he was building this? This is what I like about all of Coda's games. I mean, not that they're all fascinating as games, but that they are all going to give us access to their creator. I want us to see past the games themselves.
Get out of here!
To know who this human being really is. And that's exactly what we're going to do here. So, it's 2008, Coda starts making these games, and he never releases any of them. He doesn't put them onto the internet, he just makes them and then immediately abandons them, and they sit on his computer forever. And I think he really understood this image of himself as a recluse. At one point, he jokingly renamed his computer's recycling bin to Important Games Folder. So, you know, this was just how he worked. He tended to crank them out one after the other without even really pausing to try to understand what he had just made, until suddenly one day, he just stopped. In 2011, that was it. He made his last game, and then he hasn't made another one since. And that's
he's why not he dead.
This opportunity to gather all of his work
he,
together.
He did.
He's not dead.
He's powerful and interesting. And I'd like this collection to reach him, to maybe encourage him to start creating again. And if the people like you who play this also happen to find his work interesting, then I'm sure it'll just send that much stronger of a message of encouragement to Coda. So thanks for joining me on this. If you have a particular interpretation that I haven't mentioned here, or if you just need to get in touch, you can email me at daveywreden@gmail.com.
That paint.
Okay, that's about it for introduction. Let's take a look at Coda's first proper game.
First
As
proper
each game,
game
is loading, I'll show you the date that it was completed. This first one was made in November 2008.
November 2008, son.
Never forget. Howdy, Falls.
This game is called Escape from Whisper, and it's one of the more generic games you'll see from Coda.
Okay.
Sound, the gun has no sound. Okay, so what this is it's a collection of works by an unnamed artist, basically.
Okay.
This Coda dude who made these games, never released them, and then just decided to quit doing them altogether.
Interesting.
So this guy goes through all his creations in chronological order to try to figure out why he stopped doing it, you know?
Yeah, okay.
Why he didn't make them anymore.
That is kind of interesting. That's kind of like a museum for this person.
Security yes.
It kind of looks like this game was abandoned mid-development. For instance, you have this gun, which you'd think would indicate that there are supposed to be monsters or enemies somewhere, but then clearly there are no enemies anywhere. You can't even reload the gun when you run out of bullets.
I just realized that.
We don't really know. Maybe Coda thought that actually it was complete the way that it is. And I think that we should talk about his games for what they are, rather than for what they're not.
Enemy force neutralized. Begin shooting at
hello.
I love how you can see the bottom of the universe from this room.
Look down, look down.
Oh, hello. I would have never noticed that.
Apparently this space station has a labyrinth on it. Sure, I don't know. There's really no reason for it that I've ever been able to discern, so in the interest of time, I'm just gonna skip you on past it.
Appreciate ya. Appreciate ya.
Okay, this is the part that's interesting. The game has this narrative about the Whisper Machine and how it has to be turned off, and then you get to the engine room.
Hey, you there, in the engine room. You could save us all. That beam is powering the Whisper Machine. We could disrupt it by introducing a great enough heat signature. If you... your body could stop the beam. It's so much to...
Are you man enough to kill yourself?
Would you do it?
I'm gonna be the man.
Would you put yourself into hell?
I'm gonna be the man!
I have this...
Let me pause here for a second. What you just experienced, stepping into the beam and then dying, is probably what Coda had initially intended when he was developing this level. But when he first compiles and plays it, something goes wrong. There's a bug somewhere. And this is what happens instead.
Oh?
Jump in there. Oh! I'll float through the ceiling. Oh, yeah.
I got it.
The beam causes you to start floating. And this is an important moment for him. Because yes, this is technically a glitch, But Coda identifies something human about it, like how small it makes you feel in the face of this larger chaotic system. Or this floating could be the afterlife, a peaceful place, juxtaposed against all of the hysteria that you've just had to traverse.
Or in hell.
I don't even know. I have no idea what he was thinking, but what's clear is that after making this, something lodges itself in his brain. He wants to do more of these really weird and experimental designs. So he stops work on this and moves on to a stream of tiny little games that go in all sorts of directions. Let's go ahead and take a look at the first game he made after leaving this one behind.
So he starts off trying to make a generic, like, everyday shooter that you would see. And then he was like, you know what? Fuck this. Let's make art. Basically, where this is going.
All right.
Yep. In this game, you can only walk
backwards. Oh, I wondered. I was like... Kind of an interesting...
It's Neo!
So it's a short and relatively minimalist experiment combining motion and narrative. It is less advanced than the previous game, but actually it seems to be more focused, more complete. Code is trying to give it a unique voice rather than simply basing it on a pre-existing trope. It's a short little thought, it says what it wants to say, and then it ends. Didn't need anything more than that. Which to me is why it works, because it gets out quick. Okay, next one.
It's stupid. Now
But the buds.
And that's it. Okay, the meaning of this game won't be clear just yet. Please be patient with me for a few more games, and I promise you'll see what makes it interesting.
I believe you. But my Tommy gun, though.
Oftentimes, Coda would put...
The Tommy gun is like very fucking skeptical.
Always. Hey, look,
I wish I'd
known
him at the time that he was making these early games. He would really only talk to me about his work as he was making it. Once he stopped work on a game, like, that was it. It was dead to him. And I don't agree with that at all, but what are you gonna do?
Oh, it's getting windy. Oh.
Once you've been slowed to an absolute crawl, the door at the top of the stairs opens. So why, if Coda's not showing these games to anyone, why bother opening the door at all? Well, to show you, I'm modifying the game here so that when you press enter, it'll bring you back up to full speed so you can enter the door for yourself.
Thanks, bro.
Appreciate ya.
Appreciate ya. You're the queen dusting your jewelry while the kingdom is destroyed.
And nice and filled with little ideas for games.
I like the shark one.
Coda would often tell me
sharks are trying to eat you. Simultaneously, you're trying to eat the sharks.
He said that he knew that he was actually
a constructor. While the wall's destroyed, you're given a medal.
But that it takes time to really see that. It can be a very slow...
Stand on an egg staring at a bear for 3 hours.
Oh my god. Oh man. You are a gate.
You are a gate.
Hmm?
Ready, set, fish.
Ready to fish. Daddy-o.
And they do get more intricate and interesting as you go, too.
I figured this one.
Well, this is new for Coda. It's an actual puzzle.
A switch.
Go ahead and see if you can solve it.
Do it.
Was my brain too dumb?
So, if you close one door, the other door open.
Oh.
Don't forget that solution.
You're a gene ass.
I'm a gene ass.
We're gonna see it all.
You're an ass of genes. Something like that.
I fill up so many jeans. Oh.
So that seems to be it, right? You walk down a corridor, you solve a puzzle, you get to the end. Simple enough. All right, now I'm going to modify the game again so that when you press enter, it'll remove all of the walls from this room.
Bushki.
Well.
Right?
How about that? There was more to it than we had any way of knowing. I actually find it funny that this game comes after the stairs game, since
oh my god, look at all that.
The opposite idea. So, in the stairs game, a dull exterior concealed a rich interior. And then, in this level, a dull interior hides this fantastic outer world.
That's crazy.
Either way, I think that the point is the same. Is that most of the time, you don't get to know what you're missing. Or even that
That's
you're
huge.
Missing anything. That's not your role as a player. So if your role here is not to understand, then what is it?
Here we are again.
App.
Aha. So, this, combined with the entering game from earlier, tells us that Coda believes his games are connected somehow. It could even be that the stairs game and the puzzle game are literally connected in between this and the entering game. There's a bigger picture that all of his games are meant to play a role in, some larger meaning that we won't be able to grasp until we've seen all of them. And once we have, we can step back and start to understand what exactly that bigger picture is.
Oh, it's 2009.
Mamma mia.
Day of the meatball. Day of the meatball.
Great.
I cannot wait. Oh, hello. Walking.
Let's talk about video game development for a second. Every video game runs on what's called an engine, which determines what the game can and cannot do. So, in other words, the engine is a set of tools for game development.
I have to use the handicap stall.
Let me in there!
Games, Coda is using an engine called Source.
Damn it.
Like all engines, Source has certain things that it does well, and it has certain things that it does poorly.
Oh.
One of the things that it does very well is boxy linear corridors. That's why so many of Coda's games are set in these large, flat, empty rooms.
Oh, hello.
Is just because he's working with what the engine does well. The tools available to the creator shape what kinds of creative work they're going to end up making. You might consider paying attention to the architecture in Coda's games, to notice how they seem to stem from an engine that's very good at producing linear, boxy corridors.
Woohoo!
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Slippery slope. Okay.
Gonna make it? Oh, woo! Nailed it, dude. Nice. Alright, no fall damage, no worries.
Just don't worry about them broken legs.
Trucking along.
Rippy.
Isn't it?
Hey, that's not nice. Oh, hello. Wait.
This prison, funny enough, in Coda's original design, the door stayed shut for a full hour before letting you go.
What?
If you don't mind, I think we're gonna skip that.
Sounds good.
Appreciate you again.
This is something that he and I used to argue about a lot. You know, whether a game ought to actually be playable, whether it means anything if no one can get through it. And I would always defend that, you know, all this work goes into the game, why not make it playable and accessible? And so we just got into heated arguments over it, and there was one time that after one of these conversations, he went home, and a day or two later, he sent me a zip file entitled Playable Games that was full of hundreds of individual games, each of which was just an empty box that you walked around in and nothing else. Believe me, I played every single one of those just to find out if there was like a gag hidden somewhere. There wasn't.
Wagged his peeper to it.
Sounds like a lot of fun.
Sounds like a real little treat.
But yeah, this
it's the puzzle again.
Whole game is
with
trippy.
The exact same solution as the last time.
I already forgot.
Whoops.
There's still no clear indication of what makes this puzzle so special that Coda is going to return to it over and over. But I promise, I'll share with you my interpretation very shortly.
Tell me, Papa. Tell me, Mama.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, hello.
Here, Coda begins using a kind of dialogue system that he fashioned out of the engine's chat capabilities. Use the 1, 2, 3 buttons on your keyboard to respond.
Great. We only just met.
What are you gonna say? That's it. All they want from you.
Wait a minute.
Who are you? Eventually.
Yeah.
This game is bizarre, but it's really, like, oddly, I don't know, appealing.
It's really odd.
And so we make one last descent.
It's really what?
It's really odd, yeah.
Yeah.
What?
Welcome to the apartment complex.
It's a lamppost. Okay, I can't tell you quite why, but for some reason, Coda fixates on this lamppost. It's going to appear at the end of every single one of his games from here on out. I'll tell you what I think. I think that up to this point, you know, he's been making really strange and abstract games with no clear purpose, and maybe you can only float around in that headspace for so long. Because now he wants something to hold on to. He wants a reference.
A big, long shaft.
He wants to be leading to something. He wants a destination. Which is what this lamp
But it's all about the journey.
It's a destination. We're going to see it in the work as well. His games are just going to become a lot more cohesive, a lot more fully developed, with more of a clear idea behind them. And as we go, that idea will get clearer and clearer and clearer.
Okay. April 2009.
Ooh, I've got a new multiplayer game by some time too.
Aight.
It's like a top-down shoot 'em up kinda. Gets fucking waves of it. Pretty
sounds,
fun.
Sounds...
That was a not joke.
So first off, I'm sure you can deduce this, but this game is not connected to the internet. All of the notes that you're gonna see have been written by Coda. This was actually the first game of his that I ever played. This was shortly after I met him.
Oh,
yeah. Invisible balls.
Where I grew up. I saw him working on this very level, and it was just so different from anything that anyone else was doing. So right away I was like, I have to be friends with this person.
Reasonable.
In retrospect, I think I was probably a bit too pushy trying to get his attention. I was over-enthusiastic. But he was very gracious about it and very patient with me. And I cooled off eventually. Oh, feel free to skip over any of these notes if they're not doing anything for you. Nothing extra is going to happen if you read all of them. Either way, to me they convey a sense of loneliness. I see this person who's filled with thoughts and feelings and beliefs and has no way to express them except as scattered and unheard voices in a game that wasn't meant to be played. But it's ironic, isn't it, that in playing this game and seeing how alone Coda often felt, that we get to know him better and actually kind of connect with him.
Wanna give him a kiss on the butt?
I have to be honest with you, this idea is really seductive to me. That I could just place a scene and see the voices in their head and get to know them better and have to do less of the messy in-person socializing. I could just get to know you through your work. I think this is why I like Coda's games so much.
Or how do you open?
It felt like they let me have that connection. I felt as though
so many bleep
inviting
loops.
Me personally into his world. And then I feel less lonely.
At first I read them all and then I was like, whoa. So
too many.
Many.
Oh my god, way too many. Safe. Ain't nobody going. Ain't even.
Create the sad issue. See, you know, this game right here, technically what the game journey is.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's like you walk through the levels and come in contact with other people online.
Can't really, like, communicate.
At the end of this level, we're going to see the puzzle again. And here, I'll tell you what I think the puzzle means. Each of these games represents an idea that was on Coda's mind at the time that he was making it. And the puzzle is a way of closing the door on a previous chapter of his life before moving on to the next one. In each of his games, after exploring a theme that, you know, he might find difficult, Coda can then place this puzzle that he knows has a reliable solution, he understands exactly how it works, and so it gives him a simple mechanism.
How do you solve this puzzle?
I don't know, bro.
And because there's this dark area between the doors, a space between spaces, before you move on, you get to pause. Just for a moment, a few seconds to reflect on and let go of the events that led
you. Hey, look, there's one left at the end.
To step back and connect the pieces together.
What does he say?
To grasp at that elusive bigger picture.
How do you leave notes? Lol. Typewriters. Typewriters everywhere. Lamp post. Ah! Yeah, that's
front row.
That's some trippy stuff. Type away, man.
Porn stars die too.
Okay, this
they live forever.
Tough. It's gonna kind of just spin its own wheels for a few minutes. Hang with it.
Fishes shoot, bro. Got my dingle dangle out.
Got my dingle dangle. Got my dingle dangle in things.
Rubbing it on the wall.
Mr. Potter. Mr. Potter.
See, like, wait a minute. The whole game. and there's nothing that's particularly interesting about
Hello.
It. You just walk to the end of a hallway. Except, for some reason, Coda gets really fixated on this prison that has all of this modern furniture. And I don't know why, but he decides he needs to revisit this prison. He's gonna start over, use the same assets, turn it into something else.
Okay.
Okay, cool. Here's version two.
How about we put a giant hole in the ground?
Table.
I said I don't want it. Ten stoves lined up along the wall.
Chairs?
Honey. Vesicle.
How about a lamp?
No! Unacceptable.
Tables were invented in 1995.
Whoa!
There's a bit more to this one, but still, it's not really communicating anything. It's kind of just weird for weirdness' sake.
Ew.
So, okay, he throws it out and starts over. This time he comes at the prison idea from a different direction.
Right?
Just walk forward. Welcome back.
And of course, now the temple is gone and you can't begin the chain of events to escape.
Alright.
Here's a version where there are no bars, but you can't actually get to the well. And then a version where the inside of the prison is the outside and the outside is the inside. Let me just blink you real quick through a few more of these. I mean,
weird.
You really unloaded on this prison idea. There's nearly a dozen of them. Personally, I think it's awful to watch this, to see a person basically unraveling through their work. And for what? Like, at what point do you just go, maybe there are game ideas other than this prison that I could be working on? But Coda doesn't have that voice telling you to stop, that particular mechanism of defense against yourself.
Uh-huh.
Without it, you just spiral. And so he keeps going and going and going and going and going, and then he hits on something. And he likes it. And that's it. He's done. He stops making
Top
prisons.
Tater.
This is the very last version of the prison game that he created. And the reason I think it works is that the prison is not
Snaps.
Actually
Snaps. Kudos.
Woo!
Hey.
Hey, look, it's all...
And there's the TARDIS. Go save London from aliens.
Target. Argus, Argus, Argus. Ow,
get
D.
in there.
I want to make a phone call.
You missed. You missed again.
I'll make a phone call to my pet pop.
Hello? Who's this?
Peter Johnson.
It's a conversation. And so this is what Coda wants, is to be able to talk to someone, to share what's on his mind, and to get some good advice from someone who knows. But the irony is that even in this scenario, you're still talking to yourself. You know, all of these games so far are Coda talking to himself.
They just talked to me for
a while. They just talked to me for a while.
What?
It'll make sense.
Hang up now!
As long as you need me, baby girl.
I can see why he considers this a fitting conclusion to the prison games. After all of the obsession and frustration, just to be told by someone you can trust that things are going to be okay, wouldn't that be nice?
Here, Poppy.
I get calls from myself all the time.
Every day. And
so what would it look like if Coda wanted to make a game about talking to someone other than himself?
I don't know about it.
To me, this environment is meant to represent Coda's puzzle, with the two doors on either side and a dark transitional space between.
Trapped now.
Beautiful. It's beautiful.
I have to go talk to the...
Hey.
I'm glad as all heck that you showed up. Thought I might be having to clean the entire house all by myself, and right miserable that would have been. Everyone knows lonesome hands make lousy homes.
You'll notice that the quality of the art is a step up from previous games, including this new and improved chat system, which he
That's the story, little one. Oh, don't you worry now, we'll be through this mess in no time.
Polish of his work, and this particular game took 2 months to create as
a result. Oh, look at that, such a cleaner-upper.
That's a table I want to see. Now, would you please run into the bedroom and make the bed?
This is a bullshit.
Oh, man, how nice.
That's straight out the rug. Why'd you kiss my buns?
Not straight. Well,
Yeah. Oh, there's the messy pillow stash. Oh, look at that, I knew it.
Bloop!
Nice. You absolutely have to. Yes.
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
Yes, I have to.
And I'm naked.
Aww.
I'm just gonna watch you do. Why don't you get me out of here?
Clean that tub.
I don't wanna. Books. Books, books, books. Wait a minute.
After the intense set of prison games, this house cleaning level almost feels like cleansing. It's the moment after a particularly difficult or traumatic experience where you just need to let it sit and digest inside of you, and eventually cohere into something meaningful.
Without that rug.
I know that Coda really liked this game. Of all of his work, actually, this was the only one that he called me up to ask me to come over and look at it. This was during a period of a few months where he was, like, grossly happy all the time. Just walked around with a constant smile on his face.
God, you're making it so awkward.
Anyway.
Clean out the books.
I want to clean out the books.
Clean out the books.
Oh, why am I messing up all the books?
Uh-oh.
I'm glad he made this. I'm glad glad he found some peace.
Got an answer for you, bro.
But, of course, it can't last. The music stops, your companion...
Get me out of here!
It's time to leave. The door at the top of the hill is now open as well. Again, you can't stay in the dark space for too long. You just can't. You have to keep moving. It's how you stay alive.
Dark space was no weird forest.
A lamp post.
Which is the whole point of the puzzle doors, right? That sooner or later you have to pick up and move.
Yoink.
I really thought that was the point of it.
Yoink.
This one gets a bit goofy.
Goofy's fun. No.
Perfect.
How do you like this Mad Hatter, by the way?
I like it. It's good. It's good.
A really decent price too.
Yeah, I could. This is
like
really, one,
it's like a $9.06.
It goes down smooth.
And it's like 7%, I think.
Seven percent on the nose.
Oh. That's tasty.
About halfway through the game, the perspective shifts.
Oh, hello. Oh my god.
It's Sauron!
And you play as the teacher. And suddenly, you discover that your teacher is just as bigoted and afraid as you are. Oh, and also you can move around the classroom now.
Everyone run!
Run!
Pretty hard for this one.
Action.
I feel like it's one of the most relatable experiences that you can have. To assume that some other person is perfect and totally fulfilled in every way and completely miss all of the little flaws that make them painfully human. I think about this game a lot these days.
Lulio.
Absolutely, Dr. Phil Collins.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Go stage.
Exit stage right.
Longer than all the others for Coda to make. It was 4 months between this and the last one. That's twice as long as it took him to make any other game before this. And it's not like it's particularly complex.
All the things.
So I remember I found...
I'm ready.
You'll understand that in a second.
Oh my god.
Spooked you.
Places, everyone! Places! Places!
Be lean against that wall.
Sure will. I'm a lean. Bean. Where'd the bathroom?
Where is the bathroom? What is on your mind? Super, super scared right now.
Scary in here.
Thank you. Starting to lean into the pain.
Alright. A lamp post!
You didn't run in it.
I should have. I didn't know I could move. Alright! This is bullshit, get me out of here! Get me out of here!
The game ends with this eerie premonition of what's going to happen next.
Keep going.
The solution to social anxiety, to fears of having to perform and having to chase success, the answer for Coda is to withdraw, to hide himself away, which is what leads to scenarios like the stairs that slowed you down several games ago, where it just becomes harder and harder to access Coda's inner landscape because he keeps retreating. He just keeps backing away from possible connections to anyone other than himself. And to be honest, I didn't consider it very helpful when I first played this game. You know, it looked to me like he was trying to justify the idea of just disconnecting your world. And that wasn't what I wanted for him or for his games. Because I feel like a lot of his games are inviting me to connect. To connect with this person. To bring him closer. But what can you do?
Babucci.
After this, Coda went off and took another 5 months to make a new game.
Wow, that's a lot of time. I'm gonna grab another drink. Do you want anything, brother?
Do it! Do it!
Keep your eyes closed. Alright. I have a feeling this is some bullshit. What? Help, I'm blind!
Help, I'm blind! I can't see anything! Already.
It's pretty much impossible to solve otherwise. And there is a solution, by the
way. I got you this.
Oh, thank you.
Welcome,
please,
dude.
Please tell me how to solve this.
Fuck it, let's make some loud noises.
Crunch!
Crunch!
Hey, look at this guy. He needs some help.
Hey, it's a gate!
How the hell do you... is there even to do here?
You can do it, man.
I hey, believe look in at you. This.
I am bursting with creative energy. Stop it from happening, man.
Oh.
I believe
I can't see anything.
Bro, you can open your eyes.
Yeah, that's the answer.
I don't feel it anymore.
Like I said, I was getting concerned. First off, he's never been this explicit in his work about exactly what he's thinking. So, where's that coming from? But then, even weirder, his work has potentially
probably
stopped being...
I haven't been honest.
Not like he's having trouble iterating on ideas, but he literally just can't think of new ideas anymore. And in person, he was being a lot more distant.
I'm allowed!
You know how sometimes a person will just deflect anything that you say in order to keep themselves disconnected all the time? It was that kind of thing.
To my genitals. May they always be shiny and strong.
His games are going to get more desperate from here on out. After
that's
this
good.
Game, it's almost 6 months before he finishes something new.
Almost got like a...
I like it. A bit of
Dan's Christmas present.
Should be real excited.
Here it is. Enjoy that. That's just for you guys.
Hey, Percy, how lovely. It's been a long time since I talked to nobody.
Nobody. What's wrong? You look lost.
Wrong.
Wrong.
I got another look to give to my work. Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
Oh!
Nice. There was a machine that kept me going.
Yeah. Yeah, going again. It was a machine, and what are you looking for, a machine? I don't know where it is.
It isn't a fart. It isn't a fart.
What?
What? What?
If the last game featured Coda talking explicitly about his creative frustrations, this one turns it up to 11. Now, put yourself in my shoes.
There's
a friend whose work is exhibiting signs of struggle, frustration, anxiety, depression, even. And yet, still, he keeps making games. He keeps throwing himself into the grinder, even when he clearly doesn't have the energy for it anymore. Why?
You know this puzzle?
What do you think?
Because, from my perspective at the time,
and
just what I knew of him, this was a result of how isolated he was. He was in his own little bubble, just sitting at his computer all day, not really showing these games to anyone, not releasing them onto the internet. And so he didn't have anyone outside of himself to connect with. He had no outlet to ground himself on.
Wow,
you did it!
You can't talk yourself out of loneliness. It doesn't work that way. You can't be the one writing both the questions and the answers. Then there's no movement. Then there's no circulation. If all of your anxieties are being channeled into your work, then if the work ever fails, you have no backup and you're just going to crash.
You'll see. I've been had. Big games, easy.
Why did the walls crumble? Don't worry about it. Just keep talking, you know?
Just keep saying creation is easy. It's easy. It never stops being easy.
Yeah, that's wonderful.
That's a
Keep going.
Seeing this game at the time that he made it, it looked really unhealthy to me.
Perfect.
I was watching him do this to himself, and I hated it. I hated seeing him so trapped. It's like...
Where are the machines?
...are not worth
Where is
this
it?
Amount of suffering.
Find that. We gotta find that machine.
This is someone I really cared about. And I used to get so much joy out of seeing him create. For him to suddenly become angry
pain breezes
like this.
Effortless. More, keep going. It's like we're having sex.
This is what I felt at the time. I don't know how else to explain it. I wanted it to stop more than anything.
Incredible. That's it.
I needed more than I had ever needed.
Hey, look, they're trapped in the prison.
To stop. But it didn't stop.
Look at her.
After finishing this one, Coda takes another 7 months and comes up with a new
masturbation.
7 months. Great.
Get.
By the end of it, his penis was like.
He'll be brutal. I mean,
very good, sir. Very good. Just be warned that someone called the press, so we might have a bit of attention on this one. Also, one more thing you should know about the machine. It calls itself Coda.
I'm gonna take it.
Press.
Welcome. Hello. Great to see ya. Hello. Hey, beautiful. Hello. Can't wait to do this. I'm gonna mess this dude up. Alright, here we go. Howdy.
And of course, it's the machine.
Stopped.
Stop.
He snapped.
Stop feeding it.
Those people out there, can you imagine the pain you put them?
I've been so alone.
Apologize for leaving me. Alright, we need a drink. This is getting sad. I'm waiting for you to dink it so we can sink it. Dink it and sink it.
I know, don't you?
That machine just sounds sick, dude.
I apologize to let him know. Everybody, machine fucked up.
Hi, friends.
My followers. Aww. I'm a trebly revelry. Liberally hurt. Grounded. Let's play Retribution. We will destroy the machine.
Oh, back to the stage.
Wait 1 minute here. Wait 1 minute here!
Destroy everything.
Garbage work.
So now the work is becoming self-destructive. And I'll tell you, at the time that I first played this game, shortly after he made it, here's what I'm thinking to myself. I'm thinking that Code is stuck in his own head, and that it's having a very negative effect on him, and that all he needs to do is just start showing his work to people. To get some actual feedback on his games. It might get him out of isolation.
Can't destroy the floor. The floor is indestructible.
It's too bad.
I realized that I could be the one to initiate it. Because it would never occur to Coda to start actively soliciting feedback. So, what if I did it for him? If he could see the difference it would make to have more actual conversations...
That's a dick move, sir. Beings,
would that bring him out of his mental spiral? Would it give him confidence in himself?
Good intentions gone bad. His work? Yeah, erase it all. Fuck it all, dude. Erase
get me
it.
Out of here.
Turn it to dust. Eat it.
Oh, hey, can you get the floors on them?
Oh!
So I started showing Coda's work to people. I took this one, and
are you
I
falling?
Just played.
Can't the even
theater,
tell.
The notes,
I think
the
I am.
Cleaning game, and some of the prison escape games.
Guess you are.
I brought them to people.
That seems really slow.
Interested. I asked their opinions, and the great part is that they really loved his games. You know, the point of it all was just to give him some external reference point, but they genuinely loved his work. There was nothing for him to be afraid of.
And died. The end.
Oh!
There's the machine.
Dirty, dirty old machine.
So dirty. So
dirty. Healthy. Healthy. Yeah, you.
Forehead.
I felt like this was the right thing to do, because it's the thing that I always feel like I need to be told
the
my work.
Shit out of that fucking machine.
I am good.
Yeah, machine.
When someone really connects with a thing that I've made, when they see themselves purely in my work, got to give that very same feeling to my friend. I did something... I really felt like I'd done something good. Like I was a good person. I felt like there was a friend...
Not about
was
you.
In trouble and was on
it's ain't your story. It's ain't your story.
If I could give him this gift,
you're just
maybe I could
the shitty narrator.
The chairator.
It's the absolute best feeling.
All right, I'm gonna dink it. So happy. Dink it and
so
sink it.
Beautiful.
Dink it.
Beautiful.
Fancy. Did you watch today's GMM, by the way?
Cookies.
Yeah. It was pretty good.
Blood cookie.
So anyway,
Link's dad was hilarious.
Oh, his dad was so funny.
Really, he just kind of takes off for a while.
Love it. Love it. Shout out to GMM. Love you guys.
And I didn't
You're hilarious.
For several weeks, I guess. And so out of nowhere, one day I get an email, and it's got a private link to a new game of Coda's. This one is called The Tower, and to my knowledge, it's the last game that Coda ever made.
Before he was murdered.
So let's take a look.
The last game you ever made before you murdered.
We're approaching the end.
Coda, why are you making this? That will get.
Welcome to the shine. Welcome to the shiny.
And this is where I have trouble saying anything meaningful about Coda's work. Because more than anything else, the tower just feels distant. It feels like it's trying to distance itself from the world. It's a very cold game.
Very cold. Oh. I'm a very cold.
Take a left?
Louis?
Take a Lucy?
Wait.
This room actually has a maze in it.
What the hell?
Except that all the walls of the maze are invisible. And then every time you touch one of the walls, there's this awful flashing and noise. So the experience is really miserable.
Okay.
The game goes beyond not being meant to be played. It actually seems to despise the player for trying to play it at all. But I do want to show you the rest of the level, so when you're ready to continue, press enter, and I'll put a bridge over the maze.
Don't mind if I do.
Oh, let's just skip that bullshit maze.
Woohoo!
Right onto a wall.
And to be fair, it's not like this is the first game that's needed some modification to be playable. Like the house cleaning game. You know, that one used to actually loop the cleaning chores and you just cleaned a house forever. I had to cut it off so that you could exit the house and the game would actually end. But that game had an idea that it was actually trying to communicate. What's the deeper idea behind the invisible maze?
Spin the wheel!
The only way past this challenge is to randomly guess the 6-digit code.
Oh my god.
Like the invisible maze,
Possible.
It's frustrating to me, because it's the opposite of everything else that Coda has made. It doesn't encourage thought or engagement. It doesn't ask anything of me, except a lot of my time. If I could have reached him during this time, then maybe I could have asked him, but I couldn't.
I think we'll get it right.
I still don't really understand why this is here.
Probably guess it right.
I'll put the
That's
code
it.
On the ground for you here, though, so that we can move on.
Let's see if I got it. Let's see. One, I didn't get this one. Right, well. I got a one. And that's it.
That's it. It's the only one you guessed right. Alright, we'll have to cycle through the whole thing. What lever? Oh, yeah.
Oh yeah!
Ride that bad boy.
Piggy heel. Piggy heel. Whoa!
The switch to open this door is actually on the other side of the door.
Okay.
Meaning that it's literally impossible to solve from this side. So even if you somehow brute forced your way through the first two challenges and you got to this
Dink
point,
it.
It's actually just no way to
self-dink, self-sink.
And it's scary for me. The idea of Coda cutting himself off entirely. Just saying, You know, that's saying,
fuck
that's
it.
The end of the conversation.
End of the game.
Not giving me any way to fix the problem. I feel like a failure, I guess, when I can't fix the problem. But I can open this door for you, so...
Please do.
Let me do that.
Appreciate you.
Thanks.
Was I a failure for not understanding this game?
Yes.
I mean, I don't know why I would be. It's not like everything needs to have a solution, but I feel it somehow.
He's a failure.
I feel like I failed, and I don't understand why. I remember, it's June of 2011, I'm playing this for the very first time, and as I'm playing, I'm thinking to myself, I don't know this person. I have no idea who this person is. It wasn't the guy I knew. It wasn't my friend.
Dingleberry.
I had come to so many conclusions from looking at all of his work up to this point, and then suddenly none of them...
There's a
I had been trying
little piece
to,
of poop hanging
thing.
Off of somebody's ass there.
I was trying to get to know him, to understand who he actually was and what he stood for. I asked him,
you know, our old
so
Pomeranian
please
always
just
have dingleberries.
What his games mean
we'd
to
have
him.
To shave her ass. We literally shaved her fucking ass.
Very good.
To keep
and he wouldn't.
From getting a poop on herself.
Dingle free.
Basically.
I just felt so strongly that if I could have connected with him, that if I could have somehow...
Love that dog, but that dog was not a healthy dog. Because we breed dogs into oblivion.
I needed to see
true story.
That dog was not a healthy dog because it was like a toy palm, so it was like 6 pounds, full grown, and it
felt
sickly.
Somehow like I had
love that dog though. That was
I
an
remember,
amazing
yeah.
dog, but that dog only lived to be like 8 or 9.
Not too long.
Yeah, which I mean, dogs don't live that long, but
that's
8 or 9 is still short for a dog. Current dog should probably live to be 14. So.
I'm the reason that you stopped making games, aren't I? It's because of what I did. I poisoned it for you. I don't think I ever told you this, but when I took your work and I was showing it to people, it actually felt... it felt as though I were responsible for something important and valuable. And... the people who played them, they treated me like I was important. They really listened and cared about what I had to say. Even though I was showing your work, it was... I felt good
See,
about myself.
See, that's the thing.
Finally,
stop adding lampposts to them.
While
like,
I had that
what parts
I
of this
myself.
Are you fucking lying about?
Yeah, what's actually true?
And then you stopped. And I didn't have anything left to show people. I just had to be with myself. And as soon as that happened, there was no feeling at all. Nothing. Less than nothing. What does that mean? I'm afraid that I did something really stupid because I don't like myself.
It will be your puzzle.
That's why I'm releasing this collection of your work. Is because I haven't been able to find any other way to reach you. I've tried everything. And so a part of me has hope that if I put this compilation out into the world, and if I put my name on it, that maybe enough people will play it so that it'll find its way to you, so that I can tell you that I'm sorry. I know I screwed up. If I apologize to you truly and deeply, will you start making games again?
I won't make out with
Please.
You.
Please. I need to feel okay with myself again. And I always felt okay as long as I had your work to see myself in. Is something wrong with me? Because I know that I did an awful thing. And I'm doing it again right now. Like, I'm showing people your work. But I can't stop myself from doing it. That's how badly I need to feel something again. Like I'm an addict. There has to be something wrong with me. Can I apologize? What if I tell you I was wrong? Will that work? Will that fix it? I don't know. I don't think it will, but there's nothing else that I can do. Just tell me what you want.
You're crazy, girl.
I'm sorry.
Crazy.
Please, start making games again. Please help me. Please give me some of whatever it is that makes you complete. I want whatever that wholeness is that you just summoned out of nothing and you put into your work. You were complete in some way that I never was.
Oh shit, the room's getting tiny.
I want to know how to be a good person. I want to know smushed. How not to hate myself. Please. I'm fading, and all I want is to know that I'm going to be okay.
Whip.
Back.
Hello?
Body there? Body there?
Anybody?
Is there anybody?
It's a lamppost! Oh, it's a hybrid lamppost! Oh my.
Get on the train, dude.
More love.
Took a midnight train going anywhere.
It's like a disease.
Hey, is there anybody?
Solution.
Anybody?
Is there anybody?
Can you?
Someone had told me ahead of time that he just really enjoyed making prison games.
Drown it. Wait a minute.
Thought he was so desperate.
It's ain't water.
I wouldn't have told so many people that he was depressed. Maybe he just likes making prisons.
You're kind of an asshole.
You're a dingle.
In hindsight, you're totally an asshole.
Even now, the disease is telling me to stop. Don't show people what a shitty person you are. They'll hate you.
Yeah, man.
Master.
Darkness calls to.
Is there anybody? Anybody?
Ooh. Yeah, Gene.
Virginia. The Virginia. I love this state.
It's lotion. Lotion.
Loop that Virginia up.
If I knew that my life depended on
something
to be driven by other than validation, what would that even be? It's strange, but the thought of not being driven by external validation is unthinkable. Like, I actually cannot conceive of what that would be.
Burps.
It burns! It burns, Mas.
What now?
Burn my skin!
You know, I don't remember this part at all.
No?
Be honest with you. I played it though. I remember the narration. I don't remember.
And
of all
visuals.
Sorry, because I know that I said that I would be here and I would walk you through this, but I'm starting to feel like I have a lot of work to do. I have a lot that I need to make up
for.
And so I'm just gonna.
Yeah, you said.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay. All right.
All right.
Alright.
Let's do it.
So much terrain going on here.
Like, spooky
spoodle. Feel like I should be
bored. Spooky's House of Jump Scares. Spoodle.
Ah. Ew.
Do it again.
Ew. Ew, ew. Hear this.
You know the Spookies had to change their name?
No.
Yep. Somebody did copyright. Claimed copyright on the name, so they had to change
their name. It's ridiculous.
So it's not Spookies House of Jump Scares anymore.
Crazy.
Yep. It's fucking stupid. It's because they weren't even making money off of it.
No. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful building. It's the most beautiful building I've ever seen.
You mean okay, dude? You're having a stroke.
It's the most beautiful building I've ever seen.
Oh, beautiful.
What are the signs?
Here's
creepiness.
Leaky butthole.
Bum. Check with the swab. Quick swab.
Quick butt swab. If it's with swampy, you're infected.
You check with the pinkies.
The pinkies. Up my pinkies.
Curl it. Curl and swoop.
Curl and swoop the pinkies.
Hey, look, it's the thing that's floating to space.
Rockets in space. Afternoon,
I'm the Rocket Man. Oh shit.
I want to meet that maze. Give me that maze email address.
What's your maze like?
I want to meet that maze.
What's your maze do?
I wanna meet that maze.
Going in space, dude. This scene right here reminds me of The Unfinished Swan. I don't know if you ever played that game.
I did, but I didn't finish it.
You didn't finish.
Didn't finish it.
The unfinished, unfinished swan. I finished it. It's not even that long, dude. It's like maybe a total of 2.5 hours long. Game was pretty neat, though.
It was a cool idea. For R, my favorite letter.
I'm gonna take my headphones.
Thank
out.
You for being part of the alphabet. Friday with Dab and Papa, we had the bow-weight individual. Jesus. Jack.
Thanks for coming directly after.
Andreas Jorgensen. Turn back. Written by Helena Heroin. Performed by Helena Heroin and Ryan Rock. But this is no thanks to Aviva Pinchin, Edward Ortanis,
Shelf.
James Portnow,
Zach Isles,
Zach Isles,
Dr. Pajum. Yeah, you completed the game. Congratulations.
And congratulations to you, the viewer. Thanks for watching.
For sticking through this bullshit.
Thanks for watching.
Thank you so much.
Bill. Like, comment, grab, and yeah.
Hey, don't make fun of my intro.
I'm assuming.
Favorite comment?
What you be?
No one loves me. But especially no one loves me.
Call Android Cactus.
Make fine. I don't even see V-Sync. V-Sync. Oh, here it is. Frame rate V-Sync. Once more.
There.
No?
Yeah.
No? Alright.
There.
Yeah! Alright, so Polly is my lady.
Alright, I'm ready for action.
Ready for action. I don't even remember how to play this fucking game. if that battery at the top reaches zero, we're done. Make sure you collect all the batteries that get dropped.
Oh, good to know.
Here it is. You can do a special attack too.
How do you do that?
Question.
What?
Good question. For me, it's left trigger. I'm not sure what it is for you. Oh shit, I died!
Had that fire, son.
Got it. That matter. My god, there's so many of these fuckers.
Coming for ya. I need a box tray.
Holy shit, how long is this fucking level?
Rip it and rip it, baby.
I mean, holy fuck. Uh-oh. Isn't this level supposed to end? What the fuck's going on here?
Ugh. Ain't no go stop.
It's like a time attack? I think it is. What's going on here? There's
game
nothing
ain't,
going
the game
on
ain't
here.
Showing up.
Right, we're still 5.
I'm just a little android.
Oh man. I think what here.
Yeah. Guess one go up. Let's
find out very soon here.
Man, it's just not showing up. I don't know the fucking deal. Whatevs. Thank you guys so much for joining us tonight. Sorry you couldn't see that bout of android killing shit. That's fine though. You got to look at our beautiful faces. You got to enjoy the main event.
Or as the people in chat roulette say, really is human.
That's what they say on chat roulette?
I thought that's what someone said. One time when we were browsing the chat room.
We are hideous. We're fucking ugly pieces of dookie.
Thank you.
But thank you.
For enduring
and smelling this dookie all night long.
All night.
Alright, if you liked it, give me a subscribe, give me a like, comment. We like all those things. Join us again in the next one.
Bye-bye.
Later.